it's much easier to address specific factors with specific patients.
We think a lot, we spend a lot on healthcare, but we don't spend the money that we should on social services. Other countries that have better health outcomes than the United States have put a focus on social services. So these are things like housing, employment, support services, family support. And what we found is, you know, Tom Frieden, who was director of the Centers for Disease Control, made the point that your longevity and your health are more determined by your zip code than your genetic code. We can do better than that. So one of the things that we heard today is a model that University of Pennsylvania is exploring. It's community health workers. These are folks that come into the home, they build a relationship with the family, they find out what the underlying problems are. And so, for example, in one case, they found out that the kids didn't have winter coats, and they found a solution. They knew of a place where they could get a winter coat. They find out too that there's food insecurity. There's not enough food in the household to feed the children properly. If they address those underlying problems, then they find out that there are better health outcomes. So if we make those kind of investments in social determinants of health, we can improve the health outcomes and also do well by taxpayers.